Welcome to the Open Waters Podcast, where we are venturing into the deep of what God is saying and doing through the body of Christ and through Open Waters worship.
Come join us as we grow in unity, relationships, and true intimacy with Jesus. Let's dive in. Let's go.
Awesome.
How's it going, everybody?
How's it going?
I just started it, so.
Hey.
Gotta fix my stuff. All right.
We're back again.
Yep. Okay. Well, hello, everybody. My name is Josiah, and I'm here with my mom, Lisa.
Hello. Yep.
Okay.
Your mom, who you love so much.
Love so much.
Okay. So, I just want to let you know before we kind of get into things that we do have Open Waters on the second and fourth Saturdays of every month. But just a reminder, our only Open Waters this month was last Saturday. So if you missed it, now's your chance to cry.
Yep.
You missed out.
You can go watch it. Was amazing. The stream on YouTube if you would like.
But that's right.
It's the Open Waters Worship YouTube page.
Yeah.
So just search up YouTube and then
in
the YouTube search bar, just do like Open Waters Worship and we should be the top result.
It comes right up. That's right. I tried it. Yeah.
Yes.
I love it, Josiah, because we're live streaming. So yeah, if you missed it, just go get the recording there. You can see all of our other ones that we've done so far, including a special Thanksgiving one. But then also, if you can't make it here in person, you just want to, you're working or doing whatever, you can also catch us live streaming on YouTube. And
if you missed it, that kind of sucks, but it is what it is. You know?
We miss you, actually. We love having people here. Yep. There's such synergy when we have more people here. But Josiah, hello.
What is the topic this week?
No, that's not what we're doing yet. Oh. You can't skip over this part. Little mo about us, you know, that little thing that we do. So
yeah, what's the question this week?
We like to let people know a little bit about us. And just kind of, we love to hear back from you about you and commenting your answers to some of these questions
too. Leave
it
down in the comments.
In the comments. So what is your favorite Christmas tradition, Josiah? Go.
Christmas tradition.
He doesn't know these questions beforehand, by the way, so.
We don't have any traditions.
That's a lie. Watch out for the lightning right now. It's a lie.
Well, my favorite Christmas tradition, I would say, is probably the stockings. Just opening stockings, just satisfying. I don't know why.
Oh.
Yeah.
What do you like to find in your stockings?
It's just like an inquiry.
Yes. Shh. What is it?
Well, it would be like coffee.
Candy?
Oh, I'm actually not really a big candy person.
I know.
Honestly, surprise is the best, you know? It's honestly just the aspect of like the surprise.
A surprise. Okay. Well, for me,
what about you? What's your favorite
tradition? Christmas tradition. Oh my goodness. I have lots. I think the most important thing is I like to have family nearby. You know, things have changed so much. When I was little, we used to have
huge family
gatherings. Yeah, and we did like, we had a decorating, you know, party before Christmas. Yeah. Then we had our Christmas Eve. Then we had our Christmas Day. And it was so much fun. So I think for me, the one thing that is most important is just having my family around. But two other things that I enjoy with the family around. One is looking at Christmas lights. What?
I was just...
Besides checking the video out right now.
Just checking video really quick. I was like, I didn't know if I...
Seeing how handsome he looks.
No.
Oh.
That's not what I was checking out.
Oh, but you don't know if you pressed record?
I did, but okay. I wasn't sure, so...
Thumbs up, Josiah.
Thank you guys for watching. Anyway, continue.
So...
She likes big gatherings.
So my most important thing is people being there, my family... But with the family, I love looking at, we do this Christmas tradition where we do the drive-through light thing, and that's really fun. And then just baking things again with you. I love doing that. So anyway.
I get hairy.
Whoa. let me interpret
anyway,
for you.
Sorry.
That was.
My guess, my favorite also
my guess,
would be
my
doing
favorite.
Cooking.
Okay. Go ahead. I'll stop now.
You're funny.
I am. I'm hilarious. Thank you very much.
I like cooking.
Don't you agree?
I do the cookies as well. The cookies are fun too.
Okay.
But she's a social butterfly and I'm an introverted turtle, though.
Introverted turtles need people, too.
No, we don't.
Yes, they do. Nope. Yes, they do. All right, Josiah. So our topic this week, you're the one who's the topic king.
This week's topic is... I introduced us. So we have a setting where we like...
Here you go.
I already know. I can see
cheat
it.
Notes.
Command your soul to worship. But... flesh versus spirit.
That's right.
So who's going to win, your flesh versus or your spirit? Yo, I really butchered that. So
command your soul to worship. It is flesh versus spirit.
Okay, thanks for using your broadcast voice.
No, yeah, you're welcome.
Yeah. Oh
my. What?
I'm just...
He's over there doing something. I don't even know, and then I hear...
I'm trying to type in some note. My microphone was on my cell phone where my notes are, and yeah. So it just started writing all my...
She's not even focused on you guys right now. Sorry, guys. But we...
My bad.
She's doing something. I don't know. I was
trying to look at her notes. So command your soul to worship. Come on, my soul. Don't you get shy on me. Lift up your song.
If you've ever heard of Gratitude,
yes.
It's on Spotify and Apple Music. It's written by Brandon Lake. So sorry, Brandon, if you ever listen to this. But yes.
Yeah, that's what it's about. It's about come on my soul, speaking to your soul and speaking to your soul to worship. Our souls, our flesh is not in charge of us. Mm-hmm. Our spirits can take control of us. So that's kind of what we're talking about. Commanding our souls to worship.
Yeah. One of the Bible verses that comes to mind, I think for a lot of people that's listening to this, is that our battle is not against flesh and blood. But our flesh does try to flare up at us. So I think a lot of the time, like, we can say as much as we want to say, like, we don't battle against flesh and blood. We battle against things of the spirit. I agree. But I also think that our human flesh and our human nature comes up at us too. And so, you know,
Josiah, I'm just curious as to why you felt like this is a right now topic and something that you wanted to cover for listeners.
Christmas season, I think a lot of people think of, I'm gifts, getting things. And so I want people to know that it's about celebrating the birth of Christ. And I think one of the things that really stands out is that my church is on the 25th going to actually have a service for church, which I think is great. A lot of people can fall into, yes, you should be with family, and yes, you should have your alone time with your family and just have, you know, a good Christmas.
Yeah.
But I think the reason for the season is Jesus Christ. And a lot of people come from different paths, and so a lot of people are like, is it just one more thing to do on Christmas? But it really is just like battling against that flesh and blood.
Yeah.
Is like, we're going to go to the service and we're going to celebrate Jesus Christ. But the reason this fits is because Christmas season, it's filled with a lot of flesh, and it's like, okay, I'm going to get, but we should really just be celebrating Jesus's birth. And I think the giving part is more fun than the getting part. Yes, I think it's fun to like get things that you really want and stuff like that. But, giving is honestly where the most joy comes from, because, you know, you're giving things to people and you're bringing joy to other people's life.
That's good. So what about in particular with worship? How do you feel like commanding your soul and your flesh versus your spirit? How do you think all of what you just said kind of applies to that?
Commanding my soul to worship during this season, I think, like, amidst all the self-centeredness, I think we are commanding ourselves to worship. Because like I said, it's really easy to slip into the all about me and all about the Christmas season when it's really all about Jesus. So reminding ourselves, we talked a couple of weeks ago about memorials. It's pretty much just setting up a memorial that Jesus is the reason for the season, commanding our souls to worship. So
I'm looking at, when I think of flesh versus spirit, I think about, we've heard, you know, may you increase and I decrease. So this is how my take on it is. So in John 3, 28, John the Baptist is talking. He said, "You've heard me tell you that I am not the Messiah, but certainly I am the messenger sent ahead of him. He is the bridegroom, and the bride belongs to him. I am the friend of the bridegroom who stands nearby and listens with great joy to the bridegroom's voice. because of his words, my joy is complete and overflows.
Mm-hmm.
It is necessary for him to increase and for me to decrease. For the one who is from the earth belongs to the earth and speaks from the natural realm. Mm-hmm. But the one who comes from above is above everything and speaks of all the highest realms of all. His mm-hmm. message is about what he has seen and experienced, even though people don't accept it. Yet those who embrace his message know in their hearts that it's the truth. And so I just think, for me, when I think of this topic, it's that right there. We are so mm-hmm. involved in this natural realm. Hello, we live and we breathe and we operate from this realm. It's what's right in front of our face. But when we are engaging in really encountering God and in worship, this is where we have to step into the supernatural. And that takes us I think it's a decreasing of us and it's an increase of him inside of us. And it's also just kind of, you know, this war the Bible talks mm-hmm. about too, that we war. There's a war yeah. going on between our flesh and our spirit. And so we have to choose to let him increase in us. We have to choose to let our spirit take charge and not just to go with wherever the flesh is going.
Mm-hmm.
Are there times when you need to listen to your body and rest and mm-hmm. do that kind of, yes. And are there times when you need to say no to different things? Yes. Mm-hmm. But I think we yep. oftentimes more than not fall into this pattern of
we need to do
disengaging
this.
Yep. and really, you know, operating from what we feel like. And we don't often, there's times, much of the time, where there's a lot of feelings, a lot of different feelings. Yes.
Yeah. Just some more of the things that I would say around commanding your soul to worship is we are coming into a season of revival. I will yeah. start to say more and more that we are in a season of revival. It's an infancy, and it's our time to raise this revival, because revival... yes, it comes from God, but it is on us to sustain it. And he sustains it. He brings it down, but we are to cultivate it and right. to actually bring it to the people around us.
Take care of the baby.
And so, yeah. And so commending our soul, even though it sounds like we're to force ourselves, but pretty much we are, because your body, a lot of the times your flesh will be not wanting to do the things that the Lord and the Spirit wants to do, because it might. In your mind might seem weird, or physically it might seem exhausting, or emotionally it might seem taxing. It's important to realize that when you're commanding your soul, there's a certain breakthrough that's happening. And so yeah. when you feel stretching, it's where the most growth happens. So in the season of revival, there's going to be times where you have to command your soul to worship. And I think almost every day, like you're reading your Bible, you have to command your soul to read your Bible. You have to command yourself to read your Bible.
Yeah.
It's hard. I mean, I even catch myself being like, I have not read my Bible in weeks. So yeah. it's like, it's crazy. It's just sometimes right. like, it's really hard yeah. to like get into a routine. But then once you get in that routine, it's like, okay, this is much better. Right. It feels much more refreshing to my soul than, but my flesh is like, oh, I'm tired. I want to go to bed, or it's too early. I don't want to read my Bible this
right.
early. So
right.
it's one of those things. Commanding my soul. And then another part to this is it's finding the time for different things. I feel like I've talked about this before, about finding the time for people to come to Open Waters and stuff like that. I don't care about numbers, and I don't care about audiences. If anybody knows my personality, I'm very introverted. Not very introverted. I'm pretty introverted. I think I can be social when I want to be.
Yeah.
But
you're actually kind of fun.
When I want to be.
You're funny.
you're funny. For Open Waters, it's like a lot of people will be like, yeah, I just wish I could come. But then like, you know, some people never do. And it's like that thing. But it's not that I'm like upset that they're not coming. It's just like, okay, are you commanding your soul to worship? Or are you commanding yourself to worship? So that means, are you setting aside time to worship, or are you pushing things around so that you can come to Open Waters,
right.
or you can go to church, or are you finding joy in church? And if you're not, it's time to figure out why that's happening. But that's a different episode, different content. But so forcing yourself to worship and commanding your soul to worship is just important in finding time for God as well. Because I think a lot of the time people don't want to find the time.
Absolutely.
So that's where the flesh comes
in. Well, there's a war. It's a war. Like when you think of war, it's the struggle is real, man. The struggle is real. And so, yeah, I mean, I think when it comes to worship, that sometimes it takes time. Like I've been in so many environments where it's putting a cap on worship, how long it's going to be and different things. And I know there's a gazillion arguments for that, but I think a lot of times it takes time for your spirit to engage, for you to really, you know, take off the things of the flesh, decrease a little bit, have him increase inside of you to just quiet yourself. And it takes time so that you get to the point of really being able to have you touch God, you know, where you have that encounter, where you truly are in worship, where you're laying down. It takes time to strip all that off. And I do think there are times though, when you can just, where you do get it within yourself to just say, no, I'm going to enter in, you know, I'm commanding, come on my soul. Don't you get shy. We're going to sing, we're going to worship. And then the breakthrough comes and then you're just like coasting with God. And I think too, an example of also just kind of commanding your soul to worship and to your flesh, not operating your flesh, but your spirit is, I learned a long time ago, it doesn't matter what style is. Some people can get really caught up in the, this isn't the kind of song I like to sing. This isn't the style. This is too loud. This is too soft. This is too blah. This is da-da.
So many times have I heard, oh, the sound, there's too much bass in this. Like, there's just, that you're never going to please everybody. So might as well just stick with the pleasing the audience of one. Okay, if I'm, maybe I don't like the song. Who cares?
Right. No.
Like, I'm here to worship God. I'm not here to worship the music.
Right.
So why do
certain
I, why does
songs
it matter?
Are not my style. They're not my preference. You know, some of them are, but I have learned, whether it be from an Episcopalian, you know, whatever, to Fresh Start, where it's like rocking, you know, I can worship the Lord. I can tell my soul, you're going to worship the Lord.
Yeah.
Or I can have no music. I can have, you know, nothing, and I can command my soul to worship the Lord. Or I can be standing with somebody who's offending me and I can say, no, I'm going to walk by the spirit, not by the flesh. I recognize this is not I'm not warring against, you know, a fleshly thing. I'm warring against spiritual things. I'm going to command my soul to operate according to God's principles. And I'm going to worship the Lord by honoring that person and honoring him. So I just think, that we have to command our souls, and it takes effort. It takes a lot of effort, especially the times that it's really hard to walk in the spirit. We're more susceptible to walking in the flesh.
Yeah.
I think are when we're tired, when we're sick, when we're grieving, when we're in warfare, when there's a weird atmosphere. I mean, we live in a state that when you don't even realize it, you are, there is an oppression here. And so, and a lot of people realize it when they leave or when they first come here, but there is an oppression. And so your atmospheric pressure around you spiritually can affect you. And obviously we can, God's already overcome and broken through and stuff like that, but it does take you commanding your spirit and being aware of what's happening around you. I think when you're busy, that's also another thing that that aids you in walking in the flesh versus the spirit. What about you? What do you think?
Just realizing that it's not always going to be easy to, like, this is why we're saying command your soul to worship, because there's going to be hard times that come your way. If it was always easy to worship God, we wouldn't have to command ourselves. It would just be worship God.
Right.
And so that's where the commanding part comes in, is one of the commandments we're supposed to do is love the Lord your God with all our heart, soul, mind, and strength. And so that comes with even in the hard times.
Yeah.
It, with our strength. So we're commanding ourselves. Even when we're weak, we got to command ourselves. When our heart is weary, we got to command ourselves.
Right.
And so it's just one of those things that when troubles come, that's when the commanding part comes in. But when it's easy, it's just we get to worship God. But then when it's commanding, it's we're still getting to worship God, but it's a little bit more, a little bit harder. And so, and that's whether it be flesh or just things of the spirit that we're going against. Maybe we're just exhausted or emotionally, spiritually, mentally, or physically. It's just, you know, we got to force ourselves to command ourselves.
Yeah.
To worship.
And just there is the caveat of you got to listen to yourself when you need rest.
Yeah.
But that you can rest and worship too. Mm-hmm. We're talking about just worshiping and just letting your spirit take over. One thing that as you're talking, I was reminded of too, Bill Johnson was talking about, I was so impressed when I first heard him say it a long time ago. And then I heard him say it recently when his wife, Benny, died, was just, you know, there's not going to be another time to worship God with tears and through sorrow and suffering. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
In heaven, there will be no suffering. There will be no tears. There will be none of this stuff on earth. So to be able to worship him through our pain and through suffering or through, you know, the sorrows, you know, he lost his wife and they were believing for healing. That is a gift that he can give to God that he doesn't get to give on the other side of eternity. So our only opportunity to do that is while we're here on this earth. So commanding your soul to worship, even when it hurts. Oh, that song by Hillsong. Mm-hmm. Even though it hurts like hell, I'll praise you. I don't know the exact tone, but you know, just that song. Yes, I'm going to praise you. I'm going to praise you. And when we praise him, the breakthrough is happening. Like there's so much that happens. Just like the song that we sing, this is how I fight my battles. This is how I fight my battles. When we praise, it heals. It brings healing. It brings us closer. Mm-hmm. Like we talked last week about the Holy Spirit. It ushers him in and he gives us all the things that he is, all the things that he embodies. I mean, so yeah, even when it hurts.
With that song, you know, Surrounded, this is how I fight my battles. Our worship is the weapons we have for against our flesh and the things of the spirit. It's when we worship God, it really brings us in line with what God is doing. And it gives us just access to what we wouldn't have on our own power. So,
yeah. Yeah. I'm thinking right now, Josiah, and it's kind of a sidebar. I don't know if this is a good rabbit trail or not, just thinking on the fly.
Mm-hmm.
You know, since COVID, we've had a beautiful thing where a lot of churches went online bumped up their online presence and their tech side of things. But there has been lots of pastors I've talked to at various states, places have said their attendance has gone down. And I've heard a lot of people just talk about how, we do online. And I don't think it's bad. I'm glad that we have online, but there is something so powerful about when we come together, gather together and worship together. There is something when your spirit touches my spirit, touches another person's spirit who is saying, I'm going to worship. I'm going to make the effort to go somewhere and be in the presence of other believers and worship. There's an edification. There's a course correction. There's so much that happens when we engage in that worship in person.
It's like a grounding.
Yeah. And it's a sacrifice because your flesh sometimes, I want to stay home. I can get just as much online, but I just feel like me personally, I don't feel like it's the same as when you're in person.
People at my church actually have been saying like, you know, I was online and it's just not the same as coming in person because it isn't. But there is no space that can separate you from God in the presence. But I do believe that there is something in an atmosphere where God is moving that is unique. And so when we have church on Sundays, I mean, it doesn't have to be on Sunday. It doesn't have to be in a building. It's just, you know, we're hosting the presence in that building and God is showing up. And when you're at home and you're on your TV, I don't want to say it just kind of obscurifies the presence a little bit. Yeah. And it makes it a little harder to tap into because you're not there. You're not surrounded by people that are worshiping alongside you. You're just alone in your room. And I think a lot of the time, our mind, when we're not in the place to worship, we're kind of there. That's our home. That's where we do all of our life things.
Right.
And so I think making the sacrifice and commanding ourselves to go to church, it really separates ourselves from our home life and then from our church. Not in the sense that we want to separate the two. It's just we are now getting our mind and our body in the mode for worshiping God when we go to church.
Right.
I think that should be, it's a hard process, but doing that 24/7.
Right.
But going to church on Sundays just really gets us in the mode and yeah. gets us ramped up to worship.
Just, and you know, it doesn't even have to be on Sundays.
No.
Just gathering together yeah. where you're in the presence mm-hmm. with other believers where, you know, he is, there's true worship, mm-hmm. there's, you know, the Bible. It's just, we need that. There's something about it. And sometimes we have to command our souls to be there because it's really easy now to just say, I'm going to stay home, but it's just so important. I just want to acknowledge, mm-hmm. Josiah, that we learned a new vocabulary word here today. Obscurifies.
Obscurify?
That's a new word. I've never heard that word before.
It's just obscure.
Yeah.
I guess I would just say obscure.
It's a Josiah-ism.
Whatever.
I'm just congratulating you.
Yeah, I appreciate it. Everybody that's listening probably understands. Put it in the comments if you guys understand what I'm saying.
Put it in the comments.
That's it for this episode. Thank you. Bye.
Peace out. We're out.
No. Just kidding.
No. I just have to make fun of you. It's because I love you.
She loves me.
You have an opportunity to walk by the flesh or the spirit right now to get mad at me or to
I'm not mad. I'm trying to think of what I was thinking of before you said that. Maybe we really do need to end the episode here.
So we were just talking we were just talking about just the need to get together in
I
person
think
and
there's
commanding
just
our
people,
souls.
There's people in my life that I know that just don't go to church, and I think, you know, maybe they're at a place that they can do that, but I really would suggest going to church. I mean, I know it's just like what a drag going to church is, but I really think it's important. Just getting into the body of Christ and really like getting in a fellowship with other Christians too, because I think when you get on your own and you start doing things on your own without the body, I mean, yes, it gives you direction, but it also gives you a body to, mm-hmm. I mean, a part of the body, the real body, the body of Christ, but it gives you like your own little body to work in and operate in. And it gives you, I think, more direction in the spirit. So,
yeah.
And it just, you know, helps you grow. I think when you have people around you, it's like, I don't know if there's a good analogy for this, but just being around other people helps you grow quicker.
Yeah,
because when you're around other Christians and other people that really love God, it's mm-hmm. just like it accelerates your growth.
There's a synergy.
Yeah,
a total synergy.
Sorry, I'm just.
Is there anything else, Josiah, that you are feeling in relationship to this topic? Because it really was your heart to talk about this.
Well, no, there's not really much more. I mean, I just wanted to emphasize the importance of making sure you are pushing through in worshiping God, even when it's hard. Because a lot of the time when there's the most resistance, that's when the most breakthrough happens. Obviously, I think that's kind of self-explanatory. Maybe it's not, so I apologize if it wasn't self-explanatory.
There's so many gifts that we get when we push mm-hmm. in and worship.
Yeah.
There's so many gifts that are released in an mm-hmm. atmosphere when we push into worship. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's just...
When you have the... When you have something that's really hard to let go of, maybe it's some pain in your life and something like that, or maybe it's a gift God gave you and he's asking you to throw it up like Abraham with his son.
Yeah.
He doesn't actually take his son, but he's asking you... Are you worshiping the gift? Or are you worshiping me? And it's like,
right.
Okay, no, I am worshiping you. I'm going to command myself to worship you, even if it requires me giving up this thing that you promised me. And so that at that point, that's where the breakthrough was really huge for Abraham. It was like all this pressure built up. Oh, I got the promise that was promised.
Yeah.
And then, you know, you're asking me to pretty much just give it all away.
Right.
With no guarantee that anything else is going to happen again. And so, that's where the most breakthrough happened is when it was hardest for him.
I think, yeah, and it's breakthrough for you, and it's breakthrough for those around you, and it doesn't have to look like anything. It doesn't mean, sometimes it will mean you're at Fresh Start Church, and there, you know, you're going to go in there for a conference, and you're going to go back, and you're going to spend hours yelling and dancing, and you're like, I am tired, but you go anyway. It doesn't have to look like that. It can look like, I'm just going to go lay in his presence, but I'm going to just truly... just my soul is going to worship him, and I'm going to walk by my spirit and not by my flesh in this moment. It's just amazing.
Yeah. Just command your soul to worship.
Yeah. Now, and think of a whole room full of people that are doing that.
Wow.
That's an atmosphere where God can really move. That's,
and it's coming. It's coming to Utah.
Yes, it is. I mean,
it is going, it is here, and it is incubation.
Yes.
And gestation and infancy, whatever you want to call it. I don't know.
Yeah,
whatever lingo you like. All revolve around the same concept.
Yeah.
But yeah, I just want to thank you guys for listening to this episode.
Do you want
to
pray for people, Si?
It's gonna be short. Yeah.
Okay.
But dear God, I just pray that people would learn to come into contact with you, God, to just learn to just lean in to what you're saying and what you're doing. God, I just wanna pray that people would command their souls to worship you, God, to win the flesh versus spirit battle, God, just to learn how to just let you do what you do best, God, and to surpass their body, God, to surpass their flesh, to surpass just our exhaustion, God. Yes, there are times that we need to relax and to rest, but sometimes it's just us reaching a point of breakthrough where we need to push through. So God, I just want to thank you for all the people listening, God, just all the people here and everybody that this might touch. I just pray that this would reach the ears that needs to hear, God, the ears that need to hear, God, and the people that need to hear it. We just pray that the people would push through, through, and to reach that level of worship, God, that really makes a difference in their life, and that where they grow in capacity, where they grow in their amount of you, and their vessel is just grown and is forced to grow because of their amount of spirit they have.
Yeah.
And God, I just pray for revival to that is starting, God, that it would just be cultivated, and that we would have the soul commandingness to push into revival because it's here and we're wanting it, and we need it, God.
Yeah.
We need your presence. We need your revival. Reformation, like said, was said in church a couple weeks ago. Reformation comes from you, God, after we get in line with you.
Yeah.
We can change the country once we get in line with you, God. It's God, family, country, God. And so we just pray that that would be the case here, God. We would have revival in our churches, then we can have revival in our families, and then in our country, God. And we just thank you for that. In Jesus' name, amen.
Yeah, I want to say one thing, God. Sure. I feel like somebody needs to hear this, that you are needed. Like, you are needed. You commanding your soul to worship is needed. You saying yes to God and saying, yes, I will walk by my spirit and not by my flesh, even when I don't feel like it. It is needed. What you're doing and how you consistently push in and how you consistently rise up in your spirit and worship him, it's making a difference. It matters. It's changing lives. And I just want to say and encourage you, don't stop. God sees, and it is felt. Yeah.
Yeah. Amen.
All right. Don't forget to leave your comments, prayer requests. If you have any ideas that are burning for podcasts, please leave them.
Yeah.
On Instagram, Facebook, or YouTube, or
if you're listening on YouTube, please interact anywhere, with this video. Give us your likes for the YouTube algorithm.
Yep.
As I hear a lot of YouTubers say, give us a like, share, and comment if you're on our podcast. And if you're on Spotify or Apple, please rate. It helps us a lot to just get the word out there. And then obviously, please share with your friends and family that might need to hear this. We really just want people to get the good word and to get the good news of Jesus. And, you know, we're trying to get it in a digestible way for people. And so And if there's anything we can improve on, please leave it down in the comments. We'd love to improve our podcast in any way.
So, yes. Be kind.
Yes.
We love you.
We love you guys.
We'll be
all
back
right.
next Monday.
Bye.
Bye.
Peace out.